Welcome, explorers! Today, we set sail into one of the most rich and complex fantasy worlds ever created, the archipelago of Earthsea, a land where islands rise from the sea like scattered jewels and where magic intertwines with nature. Crafted by the brilliant Ursula K. Guin, Earthsea's geography isn't just a backdrop, it's an essential part of the story. From its towering mountains and desert plains to vast oceans, the natural world shapes every corner of this magical realm. This is a world full of powerful wizards capable of controlling the forces of nature, so let's see how much they affect the world around them. But beneath the magic lies something even more fascinating: geology. The Earthsea archipelago is clearly situated in a tectonically active region, but its overall origin remains uncertain. To better understand its formation, I will examine a few key islands individually and draw conclusions based on their unique characteristics. Could Earthsea be more than a fantasy world? Could it be a place of volcanoes, shifting tectonic plates, powerful ocean currents, and evolving landscapes? Let's find out. We begin our journey in Gont, the volcanic island where our protagonist, Ked, was born. Described as a single mountain that lifts its peak a mile above the storm-wracked Northwest Sea, Gont is the perfect example of a volcanic island. Its rugged terrain, rocky coasts, and frequent earthquakes suggest ongoing tectonic activity beneath its surface. In the short story, The Bones of the Earth, Ked's master, Ogion, literally stops an earthquake that threatens to destroy Gont Port. In this story, we learn that the long bay follows a fault in the earth. This refers to the bay where Gont Port is located, situated in the southwest of the island. If we take this passage literally, it suggests that a tectonic fault runs through the island in a southwest to northeast direction. As always, details like this remain speculative without real field data, but it's remarkable how much we can infer from a few words and a map. Earthquakes can occur far from the edges of tectonic plates, along faults. Faults are cracks in the lithosphere caused by the stress of sections of a plate or two plates moving in different directions. These events, known as slips, result in earthquakes. Faults generally fall into three categories: strike-slip faults, normal faults, and thrust faults. On Earth, there are many islands that fit this description. One archipelago that bears a striking resemblance to this region of Earthsea is the Spanish Canary Islands, a group of volcanic islands in the North Atlantic Ocean. The Canary Islands sit on the African tectonic plate, far from the plate's edges. This distance determines the type of volcanic activity known as intraplate volcanism, which form the islands. This volcanic archipelago experiences constant seismic activity and is riddled with faults. According to the ING, Instituto Geográfico Nacional, the Canary Islands are a zone of moderate seismicity with earthquakes that generally do not exceed 5.5 in magnitude. These earthquakes can result from either volcanic or tectonic activity. Volcanic islands, like Gont, form when underwater volcanoes erupt, breaking the ocean's surface. If Gont's earthquakes continue, they could eventually trigger another volcanic event. But this isn't just a geological curiosity. This volatile energy makes Gont a fertile ground for wizards, as if the island itself is alive with power. Next, we travel to Roke, home of Earthsea's School of Wizardry. Unlike Gont, Roke appears to be much more tectonically stable. This could be attributed to the protective spells that enchant the island where wizards learn their craft, but it might also have a geological explanation. In the story The Finder, we learn about the history of Roke, and it's mentioned that the island was among the first to rise and has roots deeper than the sea. Additionally, the presence of granite cliffs on Roke suggests that this landmass is not volcanic but something much older, a different type of igneous formation that may have been uplifted by the same tectonic activity responsible for the volcanism of nearby islands. I am referring to a batholith, a massive igneous intrusion formed from magma that cools slowly deep within the Earth's crust. Batholiths are almost always composed of granite, monzonite or diorite, and forming continental crust, not oceanic. This suggests that at some point, the Earthsea archipelago may have been part of a larger continent, or perhaps still is. This tectonic stability could also explain the island's magical stability. Rognol, a high green hill where the old powers are manifest, is said to reveal all things in their true form. This deep connection between rock's geological complexity and its magical significance strengthens its mythical role within Earthsea's lore, where the forces of nature and magic converge, making it the ideal place for wizards to harness and study Earthsea's primal energies. Sailing west, we reach the 90 Islands, a maze of low-lying islands connected by narrow channels and strong ocean currents. Unlike volcanic islands, these are likely coral islands, constantly reshaped by the tides. Coral islands form in warm waters through the activity of tiny sea animals called corals, which build hard external skeletons made of calcium carbonate. This material, also known as limestone, is similar to the shells of sea creatures like clams and mussels. Coral colonies can form massive reefs, with some growing in thick layers from the seafloor until they break the water's surface, creating coral islands. Additional organic and inorganic materials, such as rock and sand, also contribute to their formation. A real-world example of this phenomenon is the Bahamas, a group of coral islands located in the Atlantic Ocean and the Caribbean Sea. Reef-building corals require high-wave energy environments to maintain water clarity, deliver nutrients, disperse larvae, remove sediment, and limit competition and predation. These constantly shaping waters could make navigation perilous. For Earthsea sailors and traders, understanding oceanography, currents, tides, and winds is as essential as knowing true names is for wizards. The Kargad Lands, home of the austere temples and deserts of the Tomb of Atuan, offer a striking contrast to the volcanic and forested central archipelago of Earthsea. These islands are likely continental in origin. Remnants of an ancient landmass rise above the sea, unlike the younger volcanic islands nearby. While they are described as having low mineral resources, precious minerals like opal and turquoise can still be found, hinting at their geologically complex past. Their arid landscapes, shaped by rain shadows and high atmospheric pressure, feature barren plains, rugged mountains, and pockets of fertile lands. The mountains of Hur Adhur, in particular, create microclimates that support limited vegetation in an otherwise harsh environment. This stark terrain mirrors the culture of the Kargad people, isolated, devout, and deeply tied to their land. The scarcity of resources like metal may explain their relative simplicity in tools and trade, while their striking gemstones might have been prized for religious or ceremonial use. The Kargad Lands serve as a fascinating example of how geology shapes not just the land, but also the people and stories that inhabit it. Finally, we reach Selidor, the farthest shore, and the realm of dragons. Its barren, windswept landscape, shaped by the relentless oceanic forces, exudes an aura of desolation and mystery. Located at the far western edge of Earthsea, Selidor bears the brunt of powerful winds, towering waves, and relentless tides from the open sea. These forces sculpt the coastline, creating dramatic features such as sharp cliffs, sea arcs, and possibly basalt columns, similar to the iconic formation at the Giant's Causeway in Ireland. Coastal erosion, driven by the constant impact of waves and the abrasive action of windblown sediment, steadily wears away the land, lending Selidor its stark and rugged beauty, a fitting backdrop for its association with dragons and ancient powers. Selidor's position also places it at the crossroads of ocean currents. Here, the powerful flow of the open sea meets the calmer water of the inner archipelago. This confluence of currents could generate what oceanographers called a gyre, a large circular system of surface currents driven by wind and shaped by the Earth's rotation. Such gyres create a unique marine environment, with swirling waters that could both enhance the isolation of Selidor and contribute to its mystique as a transition between the known and the unknown. The Earthsea archipelago is undoubtedly a tectonically active region, evidenced by the earthquakes of Gont, the volcanic activity of Semel, and the presence of precious metals, which require tectonic processes for enrichment. This suggests a volcanic origin for the islands, but the complexity of Earthsea's geography challenges simple explanations. Take, for example, Hawaii, a volcanic island chain formed by a stationary magma plume beneath a moving oceanic plate. Each island in Hawaii was created in sequence, with older islands to the northwest eroding away, while new ones form in the southeast. However, Earthsea does not follow this pattern. Its islands do not show a temporal sequence, and, unlike Hawaii, Earthsea is rich in metal ores, something volcanic islands lack. Alternatively, we can compare Earthsea to the Aegean Islands, formed by the collision of tectonic plates. These islands, like the Cyclades, are known for their historical richness in metal ores, aligning with Earthsea characteristics. Yet, such islands usually exist along the edges of large continents, and Earthsea appears to stand in isolation, far from any significant mainland. So, if intraplate volcanism, like that of Hawaii or the Canary Islands, or volcanic arcs at plate boundaries, like Mediterranean, Hellenic, or Aeolian arcs, are not the answer, we are left with one somewhat extravagant but very interesting option. A more fitting analogy could be Selandia, the submerged microcontinent east of Australia. Selandia's characteristics, a mostly submerged landmass with a history of being above sea level, mirrors Earthsea mix of isolated islands and tectonic complexity. Selandia is also rich in metals, much like Earthsea. In Earthsea, the legend of Segoi raising the islands might not describe a tectonic activity, but rather a eustatic change in sea level. An ice age could have lowered the sea, revealing mountain peaks of an ancient submerged continent. Over time, these mountain tops became the islands we know as Earthsea, combining the mystique of magical upheaval with geological possibility. This synthesis of tectonics, volcanism, and myth captures the unique and dynamic origins of the Earthsea archipelago. Ursula K. Le Guin's Earthsea is more than just a fantasy world. It's a geological masterpiece, where the land itself tells stories of volcanic eruptions, shifting currents, and ancient powers. As we continue to explore these islands, we discover that Earthsea's magic is deeply rooted in the natural world. And as always, keep exploring, adventurers, because every map holds secrets waiting to be uncovered.